Welcome to the IMSAI channel, where I try to resurrect an old IMSAI 8080 computer.
Okay, let's do a little addition to our serial program that we wrote. We'll get a little fancy, and we'll use some things that are specific to CPM. So let's open up our program. What we're going to do is we're going to make some system calls to CPM that allow us to use some of the subroutines that CPM gives us for writing programs, and in particular I/O to the console. All right. So let's start out, and we're going to use some assembler commands. We're going to define, capital letters. We're going to define what LF, we want LF to mean, and CR. So we're going to remember that character turn and line feed are 13 and 10 in ASCII. That way, when we write code, it looks a little cleaner. Instead of just having a random 10 or 13, we can put in character turn and line feed, and that will make things look a little better. The other thing that we're going to do is we're going to use some commands to CPM. The way that the 8080 architecture is, there's a page of memory at the very bottom that allows you to do quick subroutine calls that are single byte instructions. And so some of those are defined in CPM, one of those being a call to the BIOS, basically, and there's a print routine inside there. So the print routine, we're going to pass a value of 9, and the BDOS is a value of 5, and I'll show you how those work. All right. And when we start, I want to write some information on the screen that allows the user what this program is doing. And we're going to do a LXID, that is move a 16-bit value into registers D and E. The 8080 has register pairs that it can use. It's an 8-bit processor, but it has registers pairs to operate on 16-bit values. And so we're going to put in there, I need to back up here. Okay. Some type of message. So we'll call it mess1. All right. And we want to move to C print. Now, print is the value of the system call to do a print command, and we're going to pass that value to a subroutine BDOS. So BDOS is one of those fancy places in memory, and we're going to pass the value 9, which says we want to execute the print to console subroutine. And that print to console subroutine knows the message is in a pointer that's put into the D&E registers. So let's go down to the bottom of a program. And we're going to our message is going to be in memory. And we'll put it after the program so the program doesn't clobber it. So after the program is usually where all of these things are stored. We're going to put in a data byte, and we're going to put a string, and we're going to say, let's see, serial test with handshake. All right. And so it will type that. And every time we type something, if we want to terminate it with a carriage return line feed, we need to put those at the end. So we'll put in our carriage return line feed. And we'll have a second line here. Tell the user what to do. Type keys and they will echo. Okay, carriage return line feed. And then the print routine is going to just take characters and push them off to the console until it's terminated with a dollar sign. Okay, let's see if we can assemble this. And it didn't like mess one. How come? What did I type wrong? Oh, it's DB, not DS. Data byte, not data. I don't know why DS. Okay, so we need to edit our program. You can see developing programs took quite a while in the old days. Okay, let's go down here, get into our where our data bytes should be. There they are. That should be a B. And that should be a B. There we go. Looks like it assembled correctly. We will load it and run it. There we go. So it's typed out a little message for us. Serial test with handshake. Type keys and they will echo. Is a test. There you go. So there are other calls into the BDOS or CPM, whatever you want to call it, that allow you to do some standard routines, input and output to various devices, and disk drive access and file access and things like that.